Alright, what is going on, guys? Welcome to the video. I hope you enjoyed that intro. That was me jamming over some of Lee McKinney's work. And that was his first solo album. Really, really enjoy that album. And I kind of wanted to discuss this guy today. I really like this guitarist. And I found the history behind him and his band, Born of Osiris, and of course, Jason Richardson, super fascinating. And so today I wanted to discuss how Lee McKinney became his own musician and broke free of some of these controversies that happened to him over his early years in guitar and music. So thank you all for joining me. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy this type of video, and I got plenty more coming in the future. So yeah, let's get into this. So Lee's first creative endeavor started at age 17 when he joined Born of Osiris. He actually wasn't the founding member of Born of Osiris, and he wasn't present on their first works. In fact, Cameron, the drummer in Born of Osiris, was also responsible for the entirety of the music for Born of Osiris's original works, which was pretty insane. He basically did everything on their first albums and EPs. And so Lee didn't join until age 17, where he began recording in 2009 with the album A Higher Place, which ended up being a very well-regarded album. And I believe he mainly contributed rhythm work. I don't know exactly what he contributed here, but I believe this was the first album that wasn't entirely written by Cameron, which is pretty hilarious. I mean, just insane how talented Born of Osiris's drummer slash multi-instrumentalist Cameron is. But yeah, this is where Lee's journey first began. From there, Jason Richardson joined the band in 2009. And if you know anything about their past, you'll know it's mired in controversy. And this is where all the craziness starts to kind of happen. So when Jason joined the band, his incredible speed and talent took Born of Osiris in a completely different direction. Jason, as we all probably know if you're watching this video, is an insane shredder. I mean, one of the fastest and most talented in the world, some would argue, at just speed and precision on the instrument. And so Lee wasn't that type of player. He wasn't up to Jason's caliber at this time. And so that did lead to some controversy, which we'll eventually discuss. And Jason was eventually fired, which caused even more controversy during this time period. And so with Jason leaving the band and then Lee stepping in as lead guitar, comparisons between their abilities immediately began. And Jason was almost entirely responsible for the most complicated songs on The Discovery, the previous album. And so Lee clearly didn't know how to play some of these solos live. And you'll see online an insane amount of videos and YouTube comments just hating on Lee during live performances. I'll bring up a famous video here. You can see just thousands of views kind of bashing on Lee for not being able to record a solo live and perform it live well. You know, it is a little hard to watch, I'm not going to lie, but it's also hard to keep up with Jason just because he was so insanely talented. And it's clear his playing style and Lee's playing style weren't exactly aligned and didn't match up. And so this kind of divided the fan base, with Born of Osiris fans really loving the Discovery album and wanting Jason to return to the band and not listening to anything else. And then there's the other half who likes all of the other albums and doesn't care if Jason's in the band. So even to this day, there's still this big divide of who's the right guitarist. And I think it's kind of silly because Born of Osiris still puts out amazing music to this day. Even their latest album is fantastic. And so this rivalry to me is ridiculous, but it dominated the guitar world for a time, and some would argue it still dominates some portions of forums and YouTube comments to this day. But as Lee continued to get hate online and get bashed over and over again for not being able to play the solos from the Discovery well, he began to work on his own music. And this first came around in 2015 with his first solo song. And the song was good. I didn't really think it was an immaculate, wonderful song. And it kind of just was more Born of Osiris-y, but no vocals, obviously, because it was just Lee. It was a solid track, don't get me wrong, but it wasn't mind-blowing, at least to me, and that's just my personal opinion. And of course, even with this track being released, comparisons to Jason Richardson continued, which was, I'm sure to Lee, very, very annoying. But still, it was a solid first effort and a glimpse into Lee's future, which eventually came 4 years later with his first true solo album. So this was a fully fledged work called Infinite Mind, and it was fantastic, an amazing album. And Lee, I think, finally decided to take his own direction. He found an insanely unique blend of melodic guitars with saxophones and synths and just all these wonderful soundscapes that were created in this album, and it just sounded unlike anything he'd ever released before. Incredibly melodic and beautiful, and lacked the just ridiculous technicality and shredding that was, you know, in some of the earlier Born of Osiris albums from Jason, and yada yada yada, all these comparisons that came with that. This was just an amazing piece of work, fully crafted by Lee with his style. And I think, you know, just from looking on the outside, what went through his mind is, I'm gonna take my own direction. I'm gonna do what I wanna make. I'm tired of just his endless comparisons. I wanna make my music and my brand. And he did it, and it was just tremendously successful. Hundreds of thousands of views on each of the songs, and they're excellent tracks. And he continues to release new solo albums, with one that just came out recently, which is also very good. And, of course, is still a member of the Born of Osiris band and has now started a new podcast. I mean, it's amazing to see his turnaround from just this, oh, the guy who isn't as good as Jason, to crafting his own work, becoming his own man, making his own music that's unique, creative, and just sounds awesome. It's just super inspiring to me, and I respect this guy a lot for taking that chance on himself and working hard and making amazing products from it. But that's all for this video. Please leave your thoughts down below. Are you guys a fan of Lee, and have you been following his guitar journey like I have throughout the years? I just found it so fascinating to see him go from just this guy who went through a lot of hate online to now being tremendously successful, doing his own thing, and continuing with Born of Osiris. It's super awesome, and I hope the endless comparisons between him and Jason Richardson do actually end and aren't endless, because they get so old, and it's like, we should all be supportive of musicians. Some can play certain things that others can't, and that's just how it is. You know, it's not that Lee's a worse musician than Jason. It's just Jason had an incredibly fast style that's very hard to replicate, and few guitarists in the world can do it. And so to sit there and nitpick on some live performances and such is just so unfair to Lee as a musician. And I'm glad to see him so successful. Definitely go listen to his albums and leave your comments below. I want to hear what you guys have to think about him and his bands and his work. And yeah, stay tuned for the next one, guys. I will be putting out as many videos as I have time for. And thank you all for watching. Peace.